Not long ago, servicemen and women who were open about their homosexuality risked losing their entire careers. But starting with the repeal of Don't Ask, Don't Tell in fall 2011, things have changed rapidly. Kirtland Air Force Base hosted its first Pride picnic this week. The Defense Department has supported gay pride events since 2012, but this is the first year that Air Force officials directed Kirtland and other bases to add Pride Month to the list of existing special observances. Sophie, the significance of this in all of y'all's minds, I'm curious here. Starting with you, what do you make of this one?
You know, I think actually the movement in the military toward greater respect for freedom for, et cetera, LGBTQ service members, I think that has really led the nation. And that it becomes a situation in which, it has definitely passed this point, it's hard to stereotype gays, lesbians, and others as weaker, as effeminate, or any of that,
sure,
when you see those soldiers. And
yeah,
so I think it's really positive. Not everybody has to be hard, but
sure,
it's a positive.
Absolutely.
Move.
Rob, your thought on Kirtland?
The gay ship has sailed.
There you go.
I mean, this argument has become more and more passé about, you know, what's going on, should we do this,
sure,
whatever. I think that the country has moved very, very far in a very short time.
Interesting leadership from a large institution. It's amazing.
Right. Yeah. Well, and I think a lot of the credit for that is really the organizations that have been involved. And disclosure, you know, I'm working for ACLU and Equality New Mexico on this issue of same-sex marriage, and messaging this issue as a discrimination issue, because there's still areas in rural New Mexico that are not, where people cannot safely marry same-sex couples. And so, you know, the leadership of those organizations and the amount of work that they've done in the community is shown up in issues like this. And it's really great to just see the first ever, you know, gay pride picnic this week.
Right. And no hole opened up in the ground. There were no, you know, nothing horrible happened.
I thought you were talking
about
pride being in the Air Force. I was shocked that this over, I mean, I thought we were talking about like Air Force pride, but, you know, I'm surprised.
That counts too, though.
I'm surprised to hear
that. It
could
be one of the same. It's all right.
You know, as Rob said, you know, the ship has sailed.
The
gay ship has sailed. I thought that this was all, you know, I thought this was all put to bed with the village people when they had the guy in the, you know, in the Navy, and I thought that everything was going well. I think, you know, the military has long been historically on the cutting edge of doing things. You know, they were the first place that the government, that the country decided to look at integration. You know, I mean, the things they've done historically. So I think when you see, you know, for people that are paying attention, when you see the military doing this, it's time to start paying attention.
There you go. You're an ex-Marine. If the Marines
ex-Marine, it's always a Marine.
No, of course, that's the first rule. Sorry about that.
No former,
If the Marines recognize Pride, would that give you any heartburn at all?
No,
okay,
not at all.
I didn't think so, but I was curious.
Doesn't bother. You know, this whole discussion is, you know, I understand that there's people out there that think there's a sanctity of marriage and all,
sure,
of that stuff. And look, I think everybody should be married. They should all feel the same misery that we have to feel. So, you know, just a joke.
I'm happily married.
Ask your
husband.
Of course,
husbands. It's 2 months.
Right.
I'm 2 months in.
No, you know, this has always been something that's never bothered me.
Yeah.
And I just find it interesting for those that it does bother and has bothered. It always just makes you go,
Here's what you say, though. The gay ship has sailed. That's really all you have to say.
I'm coined a phrase today.
That's right.
I think we should end with the Navy.
The
Rob Nicoleski.
We need to exit this with the village people in the Navy.
There you go.
All right.
Thank you all for being here. Really appreciate it.